History of English Literature, Modern Age, 1892-1960, Part A. Brief questions with answers. Question 1. When does the Modern Age begin? Answer. Modern Age falls in between 1890 and 1960. Modern Age is an outcome of Victorian Age. At the end of Victorian Age, we trace the beginning of Modern Age. Question 2. What do you understand by Modernism? Answer. Modernism refers to the doctrine or ism of Modern Age. The literature of Modern Age reflects new tendencies and changes in society, politics, technology, science, and religion. In other words, the new isms of 20th century, such as realism, naturalism, feminism, existentialism, transcendentalism, surrealism, etc., are known as isms of Modern Age. Question 3. What are the literary features of Modern Age? Answer. The literature of the Modern Age reflects some distinguishing features like breakdown of values, resurgence of poetry, dominance of mass media. Modern literature as a whole was pessimistic and leftist in overtone. Question 4. What is Boer War? When does it begin? Answer. Boer War took place between 1899 and 1902. It brought about a change in imperialism. The imperial power realized the need for the reformation of social problem. It brought about a reawakening of social consciousness. Question 5. Who are the important novelists of the Modern Age? Answer. Modern Age produced a host of novelists. The prominent novelists are E.M. Forster, Joseph Conrad, D.H. Lawrence, James Joyce. Okay. Question 6. What issues of life are reflected in the novel of Modern Age? The colonial misrule and the hard life of industry and miners are mostly reflected in the 20th century novel. Moreover, the psychological conflict of human relationship is also focused in the 20th century novel. Modern novel has become a vehicle of social criticism. Question 7. How is a modern novel different from Victorian novels? Answer. Victorian novel was influenced by romantic ideas. It has a moralizing tone. On the other hand, 20th century novels present a realistic picture of life. It is pessimistic and no longer didactic like 19th century novel. Question 8. Who were the major dramatists of the Modern Age? Answer. Drama during the Victorian Age was almost barren. With the advent of modern era, the dramatists wrote plays concerning the issues of modern life. There were dramas of ideas and poetic dramas. The Irish dramatists came into focus in the early Modern Age. The important dramatists are George Bernard Shaw, John Millington, Sean, Henry Arthur Jones, etc. American dramatist Eugene O'Neill is also considered as one of the great modern dramatists. Question 9. What is meant by poetic play? Answer. Poetic play or one act play is an innovation of Modern Age. Since play is categorized as poetic play or one act play, poetic play is a development of the traditional play or conventional play. It focuses the grim reality of life and concentrates on the sufferings of one single character. Question 10. What is meant by drama of ideas? Answer. Drama of ideas is a kind of drama written by George Bernard Shaw. Shaw's dramas are categorized as drama of ideas because in the sort of drama, he presents witty, humorous incidents and flippant characters. But beneath these humorous situations, there lies a serious philosophy. Hence, Shaw's plays are called drama and philosophy or drama of ideas. The ideas of modern life is conveyed through unimportant incidents and funny characters. Question 11. What are the characteristics of modern Irish drama? Answer. Irish dramatists brought about a revolutionary change in English theatre. Most importantly, it showed a change from patriotic and romantic interest to the past of Irish history and love for the unsophisticated people. Irish drama dealt with the superstition belief of Irish people, the life they live, the crisis they suffer from, and the struggle they go through. For example, Sinch protagonist Moria suffers, as does Ireland. She lost all her sons, and Ireland lost all her children because of famine, disaster, a calamity, and war. Question 12. What are the major modern poets? Answer. Modern English poets have set a new trend in English poetry. Poetry has become urban and cosmopolitan. It is no longer traditional poetry of rural, natural life. Modern poetry invokes a nostalgia for city life. The major modern poets are W.B. Yeats, Hopkins, Eliot, W.H. Auden. The modern poets have adequately reflected the disease of modern life in their works. Question 13. Who are called Georgian poets? Answer. Georgian poetry comes after the Victorian era. The Georgia poets tried to revitalize poetry. They wanted to free poetry from the Victorian ideas, ideals. They returned to natural beauty like moonlight, hills, birds, portrayed English landscapes realistically. The important poets of the Georgian era are Robert Brooke, Edmund Blundell, Walter Delamere. However, the poem of Eliot, The Westland, puts an end to Georgian poetry. Georgian poetry shows a nostalgia for country life. Eliot's poetry shows a nostalgia for city life. Question 14. What are the characteristics of modern poetry? Answer. Modern poetry is characterized by the note of realism, sense of isolation, loneliness, ideas of psychology and politics, love for working class people, and in rigid style, it is symbolic and makes use of allusion and myths from different branches of knowledge. Question 15. What are the characteristics of post-First World War poetry? Answer. The poetry of post-First World War presents a barrenness of modern life. It shows disintegration, boredom, religiouslessness, and excessive love for materialism. It makes use of images and symbols. The fragmentary style of modern poetry is reflective of its theme. Question 17. Who were the prose writers of the 20th century? Answer. Apart from the novelist, there were some prose writers and translators in the modern age. For example, I.A. Richard, he was a scholar and critic. Gilbert Murray was a translator. Huxley was a traveler. Sir Winston Churchill was a biographer. G.M. Trevelyan was a historian. Another historian was A.G. Toynbee. Virginia Woolf, Priestley, Huxley were essayists. Question 18. How does Eliot's poem, The Love Song of J. Alfred Prufrock, denote the characteristics of modern man? Answer. Prufrock embodifies the characteristics of modern man. His decision, frustration, sense of belonging, identity crisis, etc., contribute to his becoming a modern man. Eliot draws an analogy between Prufrock and Hamlet in order to show the triviality of Prufrock's life. Question 19. What does Eliot mean by objective correlative? Answer. Eliot's poetry is the revelation of new poetic technique. He is critical of romantic notion of poetry. He advocates impersonal theory of poetry. He believes there must be a balance between facts and imagination in the composition of poetry. In other words, there should be intellectualization of emotion or emotionalization of intellect, sensibility. Eliot advocates that emotion must be justified by fact. This is unified known as theory of objective correlative. That is, subjective feeling of the poet author must be justified by objective fact. Question 20. How does Eliot refute romantic notion of poetry? Answer. Orsworth advocates that poetry is the spontaneous overflow of powerful feelings. Taking its emotion recollected from tranquility. But Eliot opposes romantic notion of poetry and says the progress of an artist is continual surrender of the self and extinction of personality. According to Eliot, the poetic process involves a reconciliation between tradition and historical sense and individual talent. Question 21. What type of poet is W.B. Yeats? Answer. W.B. Yeats is a patriotic romantic poet of Ireland. Yeats in his poetry wrote about Irish history, culture, and their struggle for freedom. His romantic love returns into patriotic love, patriotism. It is said Yeats owes to Ireland and Ireland owes to Yeats. Question 22. What is Imagist movement? Answer. Imagist movement is a movement of 20th century literature. Modern English poetry is influenced by Imagist movement. Ezra Pound was the leader of Imagist movement, which included other poets like T.E. Hume, Hidadu Little, John Fletcher. The poet of this group used images to create an atmosphere which symbols and language failed to convey. Imagist movement is a reaction against excessive romanticism. Imagist movement brought about the quality of accuracy, definiteness, and straightforward description. It used free verse. Question 23. What is the effect of war on literature? Answer. 20th century literature is an outcome of post-war civilization. It shows the breakup of Western civilization and disorientation of modern man. War destroyed not merely the physical infrastructure that is building, crashing, or burning of offices, but a spiritual breakup. War created mistrust and loss of faith in other values of human society, and the erosion of values is reflected in the literature of post-war civilization. Question 24. What does feminism mean? Answer: feminism is a 20th century movement for the freedom of women. Feminism asserts freedom for women, that women must have political freedom, intellectual freedom, social freedom, religious freedom. A woman should not be treated important only emotionally. She is an equal partner in social reformation. Therefore, feminism is a movement that deals with the life of average women, their problems, their hopes, dreams, and expectation. In short, it is called Women Live. Question 25. What are the seven pillars of wisdom? Answer. Seven Pillars of Wisdom by T.E. Lawrence is a unique non-fictional prose of the late 20th century. It is a book of travel and an autobiography. It is a mixture of history and romance. The book contains Lawrence's account experience as a traveler and his recollection of the revolt of the Arabs against the Turkish in which he participated. In a sense, the book contains facts of history, but he presents it in the style of a romance. This book is described as a great romantic war book. Thank you, viewers, for watching. If possible, please share my video.